at 10 a.m. The purpose of this letter, therefore, is to forward to you the signed proclamation for your further management. Signed, Dr. Kenneth Omona, the Principal Private Secretary to His Excellency the President. Of course, that news coming in from State House indicates that the election of Speaker and Deputy Speaker that was due on the 21st of May will now be on the 24th of May, according to this statutory instrument, a proclamation that has been outed by the President. I'm Chris Higenye. Let's now delve into the news mainstream. Preparations for the president's swearing-in ceremony tomorrow are in high gear, and much of what's supposed to be done has now been finalized. This has been confirmed by the Minister for the Presidency, Esther Mbayo. The Minister for Health, Dr. Jane Ruth Acheng, also says that new guidelines that have to be strictly adhered to have been released. The updates come after a security meeting that was held this evening at the Kololo ceremonial grounds. Let's have the details in the following report.
Swearing in of the president-elect is tomorrow. We're just a few hours away from tomorrow. And from the look of things, everything is set.
All security operatives, including the organizing committee of the president's swearing-in ceremony, met this evening at Kololo ceremonial grounds for the final security meeting.
The essence of this last meeting is to make sure that we harmonize. And when tomorrow comes, we just move on as expected.
Officials from the Minister of Health, Electoral Commission, among others, also attended the meeting. According to the resolutions from the meeting, the Minister for Presidency, Esther Mbayo, confirmed that all was set for the day.
When you work as a team, everything flows. I've gotten reports, and where I feel we need to harmonize, I've commented, the minister has commented. So we are just ready for tomorrow.
A special tent for Muslims has also been set up at Kololo.
As you see, various tents have been put in place. The tent for the principal and his invited guests, the various visiting heads of state and the visiting heads of delegations. They are already put in place. We have a tent for the VIPs. We have a tent for other invited guests.
The Minister for Health, Jane Ruth Acheng, issued strict guidelines which have to be obediently followed tomorrow by all participants attending the president's swearing-in ceremony. These include masks have to be put on in the right way, covering the nose. Each tent will have 200 members as stipulated in the guidelines to prevent COVID-19. Each tent will have sanitizers. Movements will be limited. Only nature calls will be allowed.
Everyone coming here has been tested using the PCR test. And some of the service providers have been under quarantine for the last 14 days, including testing, to ensure no cross-infection to anyone, not even our incoming guests, but also no infection here at the venue. So the procedure here tomorrow will be very clear. When you get in at the entrance, you will be taken directly to your seat.
COVID-19 results for all participants who were tested will be given at the entry of Kololo ceremonial grounds. Only those whose results are negative will be allowed.
As the health sector and on behalf of the scientific advisory committee, we are pretty confident that the work that has been done by the presidency and the entire national organizing committee is acceptable to the standards that will ensure that everybody is safe. So we want to wish the president-elect a very good swearing-in ceremony, a beautiful day, but also to reassure Ugandans that every precaution has been taken.
Brigadier General Flavia Biekwaso, the spokesperson of the UPDF, assured the public that there is no need for panic.
The security has been heightened. As you've seen downtown or around town and around the parts that surround Kampala, there's good deployment. And the purpose is to make sure that everything is secure. The purpose is to make sure that we deter or we prevent any event, any occurrence of violence. And the other purpose is to make sure that there are no, we check all the threats. I can only tell the Ugandans to feel safe and secure. For those ones who want to see the new dawn, yes, tomorrow it's happening. Yes, that one is for sure.
By press time, final touches were still being carried out at Kolo to ensure that the grounds are ready to host the ceremony. Sniffer dogs under the guidance of police bomb squad were seen sniffing into all corners of Kololo grounds to detect any kind of explosives. According to the program, the function will officially start at 8 a.m. with the military guard, and participants have been urged to keep time. President Museveni will be sworn in for the sixth term to take on the mantle to rule Uganda for the next 5 years. Story compiled by Jaliat Namwaya for the news in Kampala.
As NRM fraternity and as Ugandans who voted for Yoweri Kaguta Museveni, we are so excited.